Early this month, legislators from various regions across the country reported to Parliament that government hospitals are experiencing shortage of drugs. In response to the concerns, the Minister of Health, Dr. Jane Ruth Acheng, attributed the challenge to the Minister of Finance, which she blamed for delaying to release funds to the national medical stores to procure essential medicines.
NMS is to operate on if myth. Let money be provided by the first day of the quarter. Let it be treated as a unique entity. The others can wait, but let NMS get money.
This evening, human rights bodies fighting for the rights of the patients decided to take a tough decision by dragging the Attorney General and the National Medical Stores to the courts of law over scarcity of drugs in the government hospitals.
We have gone to the High Court of Uganda to institute a case against the Attorney General and the National Medical Stores, calling upon court to intervene because the failure to distribute timely medication affects Ugandans. So we thought that regardless of whatever happens between the entities, and the entities would even include National Medical Stores, Ministry of Health, Ministry of Finance, any Ugandan should not be at the one struggling, regardless of whatever the conversations are. So to the vulnerable Ugandans who may be struggling because of lack of essential medicines in the government health facilities, simply because maybe an agent did not do their work on time or has failed to provide money or distribute medicines, we think that the courts of Uganda can actually come in and provide solutions such that Ugandans are not affected.
The activists have laid out several grounds why they decided to engage court. They demand that the government establishes and maintains a system for proper, effective and timely distribution of essential medicines. They want the government to ensure adequate funds to the national medical stores. They are demanding national medical stores to provide quarterly reports to Parliament regarding progress made in ensuring timely distribution of essential medicines to the government hospitals across the country. They are also advocating for Parliament to revisit the current funding mechanism to the health centers.
People struggling or affected by diabetes, by sickle cell, people living with HIV, even people having malaria, even if it was any other disease. If I moved into a facility once and I don't get medicine simply because it's not there, and they tell me come back another day and I come back, ideally it means I am not following my structure of taking the medicine, and eventually it is that person's health that is being affected and eventually their life. So because what we are discussing is a matter of lives of people, it should not really happen in a situation like this that Uganda can even come up and start discussing issues of drug stockouts. Because at the end of the day, we are speaking about lives of people.
The major argument is that scarcity of essential medicines in government hospitals poses a big risk to the lives of Ugandans, especially the low-income earners, with some feared to have lost lives. Story by Juliet Namuaya for the news.